Could have gotten a flight between $315, $730 to drive out there, pretty expensive. Not that anyone would necessarily choose to drive out there, but at the then current rate, 54 cents, 54, 45 cents per mile, it got pretty steep, could get pretty steep. Let's see, so in the B part of that, the mileage is payable for to only one or two persons. So basically what that's getting at is if you ride share, everyone riding in the car is not able to claim mileage reimbursement. Just the person that owns the vehicle or driving the vehicle. I've got a typo there. So that should be C for rental vehicle or D for rental vehicles. Rental vehicles are not to be used unless some extenuating circumstance exists. And I would recommend that it needs to be substantiated and come to the mayor for approval. And then I know that I get a typo instead of being C, that should be E. Needs to be supported by original receipts. Section B, lodging. Rewritten to discourage use of lodging accommodations that are within 60 miles or 60 minutes. Again, unless there's an extenuating circumstance or demonstrated hardship, it brought the mayor's attention to grant an exception. And an example of what might be considered extenuating circumstances is they're changed to section C, subsistence. D, spouse or companion travel includes, should not be at the city's expense unless bona fide public purpose serving a specific item or official city business has been established. That's the most significant change to that section. The rest pretty much parallels what was previous in this section. What would be reimbursed is the cost of airfare. Meals would not be reimbursed. Lodging would not be, but typically lodging is for one, two people staying in the same room. It's not an additional cost. Section E. City encourages use of the most effective means of telecommunication. The city provides elected officials with a monthly stipend for mobile phones, which only would cover cost of phone usage. So going through the rest of that section, basically what the existing policy doesn't address this at all, and what I sense may be experienced is most of us have cell phones, but there may be a situation where your cell phone doesn't work in a venue, and there's an important call that either needs to be made or you're receiving one, and there may be some charges that accumulate because of that. Policy didn't, I'm not saying this is per se a problem, but the policy didn't really address that. I thought it was wise to add this as a means of allowing it and how it would be handled. Again, I think most folks have cell phones and that's what they're using to handle their communication. Section 8, there were two sets of changes. Scrolling down to paragraph 5. Credit card use and availability of a credit card is a convenience for charging expenses that are directly related to official city business having a valid public purpose. On the existence of two occasions that an elected official uses a credit card or submits a credit card charge for items that per diem was or will be paid, or where there are prohibited items charged on city credit card, the elected official's city credit card would be terminated for a 12-month period and reinstated thereafter at the discretion of the mayor. What I mean by two occurrences would be two different trips, two different travel experiences, not necessarily two incidents in one travel experience. 6, basically just references that the appropriate necessary forms will be revised and are created and be considered part of the policy rather than having, because in the past we had a form that was there and we made, I think in October or December, there was an interest to change and add a form. So we just saw this as a little bit easier, more flexible way to introduce revisions to forms that the council may see as necessary and where finance identifies it as approved. Questions?
Move that we accept the trail policy with the change.
That's second.
I'd like to make a substitute motion. We do what I was talking about, that each council member will be allowed $4,000. And also the mayor pro tem will be allowed $4,000. Straight across the board. And then any money not spent by council member goes back into the general fund. Because that's the only way it's going to be fair to the taxpayers. No other cities is doing anything like what we're proposing. That's to me way out of line. So that's my motion.
I have a problem with the spouse and the companion.
Oh yeah, I thought that had already been the spouse.
I want to say that I don't think the taxpayer should incur the expense of a spouse or a companion traveling for any reason.
I don't think
the taxpayer should have to pay for it.
Reason I didn't address that under Gary was the fact that he had it in his on down the line.
So if that's added to your motion, I'm in agreement.
Yes. I'm with that too.
I thought it changed for a spouse couldn't drive. I mean a companion.
No, it has exceptions.
There is, I think the manager's proposal notes that the only time you could have companion travel is if there is a public purpose identified for that companion's travel.
Yes.
So that would mean for the convenience.
Yeah.
Yes. So if for the convenience of a member would not be.
Okay, let's just go ahead and throw it in that a spouse is not going to be accepted as a city paying to.
Would you like to say spouse or companion? That way.
Yes, right. A spouse or companion.
I've got two motions.
You have a substitute motion. Yes. The substitute motion is seconded?
I'll second.
The substitute motion will be voted on first, and if it prevails, it overtakes the original. So. But
okay.
I think just for purposes of, and I'll defer to the clerk, that the original motion was to approve the proposed changes. The substitute motion approves it with the following additional changes, limiting the fund per member to $4,000 per member, including the mayor and mayor pro tem, and I believe specifically eliminating companion travel in general. So it would not be that there's an exception, but there would be no companion travel.
Right. And in the early discussion, Councilman mentioned something about leftover funds going back.
No, that goes back to the general.
And then all unused funds at the end of the year would go back to the general fund. And there would be no, which means there's no transfers permitted. But is that what you're saying? So then that would also be an amendment to, you're saying that all unused funds, so you're saying that there would be no. You would modify the manager's proposal so that there would be no transfers of funds.
Back to the general fund.
The only transfers to the general fund. There would not be transfers.
That's right.
To members, because the manager's proposal outlines it is, if a member determines they are not using the funds, they can transfer it to members that have requested to receive funds that have notified the mayor and that's divided equally. You're saying no transfers of. So actually, your substitute motion makes three sets of changes.
Mm-hmm.
One, it lists that it's $4,000 per person, regardless of position.
Except for the mayor.
No, I think actually he said $4,000 across the board.
He changed that.
No companion travel and no transfers of funds.
All right, I have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? Question or discussion?
I just have a question, so we're not going to be transferring the funds like we were doing since October.
Right.
So
that's an amended motion.
That would be if that substitute motion passes.
Pass.
Yes, but I'll defer to Councilmember Jordan since
it's. Well, that was going to
other questions? Not all in favor of the motion?
Aye.
All right, now raise your hand so we know. Two, one, two, three, four. Okay, you get that, Bridget?
Yes, sir.
All right, now, what we do with the other?
Mayor, you need to take the no's as well, because if you don't, then they're counted as ayes.
All right, yeah, okay, I'm sorry. All right, no's. Okay, you got that, Ms. Bridget?
Yes, sir.
Now, what happens to those? That die the other motion?
That substitute motion that replaces the original. So the proposal, the policy is passed with the changes, Councilmember Kazai's substitute motion suggests.
Okay, that's fine. Item four.
And just so, and I think for clarification's sake, council, is your intent that this be effective at the next fiscal year? Or is it effective immediately? Because some of those changes would then impact travel taking place within the rest of the fiscal year because of the fund changes and the transfer changes.
Next fiscal year, I would ask if July 1st.
That would be.
July 1st.
July 1st.
Next fiscal year. Do we need a vote on that?
I think.
I think we noted it.
I think it's noted.
Okay, I mean, that's all you need. Okay.
Unless council wishes it to be otherwise, we would assume that you need it to be effective July.
Thank you.
All right.
Discussion and direction.
Anything else on item three? Here none. Item four, request to consider moving location of public comment period of city council regularly agenda. Gary, you want to address?
Mayor, I feel like if the public wants to come out and speak or voice a concern, they should be able to do that at the beginning of the meeting instead of having to sit there for an hour and a half or 2 hours or whatever. Now, this doesn't affect if we've got a specific thing that calls for public comment. This is just general concerns, general comments to council. Should be at the beginning, again, giving the people the ability to speak without sitting there and having to wait on us to get through everything else.
When you say general concerns, I mean, how do we know we're going to be general concerns?
Well, I'm going to make that clear, that they can't come up and talk about anything that's already on the public comment, like a zoning amendment or something of that nature.
You're making that a motion?
I'm making that a motion.
I see.
All right. Have a motion and second. Any discussion?
I would say that my only concern is we need to have a definite time limit. I don't think we'll have an overwhelming number of persons, but they're all welcome. But some of them get someone love to hear themselves speak. And
well, we need to hold them to the 3 minute time limit.
Yeah, so if we have to get Bridget a green light and a red light.
I think that's what the county does and the school board.
The county does it, the school board does it, public comments up right up front.
You mean after the mayor calls the meeting to order?
After the mayor calls the meeting to order.
So it would be before proclamation and recognitions, or is your intention to have the public comment then say, for example, if you did it today, the wrestling team from Cattle would have to wait for the public comment period then?
I'd say if we've got a recognition and a proclamation, that should go first.
So would it be then before the consent agenda but following any proclamation?
Yes.
Recognitions? Would you please amend your motion to state that?
So it'd be before the consent agenda, but after any recognitions or proclamations.
Okay. I have a motion. I have a second. Any other discussion?
And the other thing we would ask is if you would allow us to bring a resolution back making these changes, because you did this by resolution in 2005, so we would need to make those changes if you would allow us to bring it back as a resolution in April.
Yes.
So it would not be effective, just so you understand, until the May meeting.
Right.
Have a motion, second. Any other discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
No.
You got that, Ms. Bridget? 1 May. Anything else to bring up at time in fact five? If not, we'll reach this for any lunch you may have back there, don't you? And we'll reach this back there and be back at 6 o'clock. All right, got your meeting.
Yeah.